Greetings, DS106 people. The office is just crazy. No one is here. This morning I came in and the office is completely empty. I don't really even know what to think right now. It's been a hard week for me. As you know, I started here last week and I had my doubts from what I had been seeing on Twitter about Jim, about his sanity. And when I got here, it's like Jim was missing. I had to deal with his relatives and field questions from them. Luckily, they were able to help me out a bit last week. But then Martha, well, let's just say Martha hasn't been herself. I don't know what to think anymore between Jim and Martha. And now the office is completely empty and I'm left here by myself. And there's a note on my desk that just says press conference at 2. And I don't know what to think anymore, but I jumped on my laptop here and I just wanted to reach out to you all and to broadcast this. I think I've got the feed here for the press conference, and Agent Kim is going to talk to us a little bit about this investigation and what's going on. I don't know what to expect. Let's go to the feed. Here is Agent Kim Droom with the latest on what's going on with DS-106.
I'll take questions at the end of my discussion here. This is Detective Kim Droom. Approximately 12 hours ago, which would be 2 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, we have obtained a suspect in the ongoing Oblivion case. Some of you may have been aware of the bloodbath up at Camp Oblivion. Well, I'm here not only to ultimately take some of your questions, but also to sort through some of the evidence here live on TV, just to dedicate and to show that we are dedicated to transparency with solving this case. Like I said, we do have a suspect in custody, but there are some serious questions that this could be part of a much larger conspiracy. So I'm going to go through a protocol at the end of this press conference where I'm asking everyone who's been a part of DS-106 or DS-107 to in many ways archive anything they've done up to this point, because it will and can be used as evidence. Once again, I'm Detective Kim Droom, and let's look at some of the evidence we've actually obtained thus far. We obtained one Chipotle napkin with the website campoblivion.info on it. And if you go to that website, there's some interesting links back to some of the most important elements of this case that is still unraveling as we speak. Some of you may be familiar with these one pair of Ray-Ban aviator sunglasses, which were found at the crime scene of Camp Oblivion, as you can see behind me, the police line. I am at Camp Oblivion, and these were found along with a New York Yankees cap that someone took out of their evidence bag and put on someone else's desk. That's right. We also have one owl kite. Not sure if anyone knows the owl kite. We have one bloodied ball peen hammer that we're looking into, very important part of the case. We have one roll of duct tape, just run-of-the-mill, everyday duct tape. But how it was used, people, turn your stomach. We have two rolls of film, 35mm film that we're getting developed as we speak. Hopefully this could lead to more clues about the bloodbath at Camp Oblivion. Oh, also, one second. I'll be right back. We have one audio tape. Camp Oblivion Part 2 and Part 3. I'm not sure what this is, but when we listened to it, there were a lot of power tools. It was pretty grisly. So we're keeping that out of the public record for now. But there was 10 minutes of some of the most disturbing audio I've ever heard. And I've been around 25 years. I'm a vet here, Kim Droom. And this stuff, unfit for work, to say the least. Okay? Interestingly, we found one dress jacket. Blue, navy dress jacket. As such, on the scene. Very interesting. Indeed. Yes? Okay. We've also got some very important files. Very important files. All sorts of files, interesting files for those people who weren't the files. These will be available, made available on the website, DS-106, but they're very interesting files. Anything from backpacks to a list of names, some crossed off. Very interesting. Very interesting indeed. We have some Chipotle chips with hot sauce. This is my lunch. I'm not sure how it got in the evidence bin. But at the same time, that's a recurring theme, Chipotle. We also have a hard drive. A hard drive was found on the scene. It's unclear who the hard drive belongs to, but it's 20 megabytes, which is not a lot of megabytes in this day and age, from what I understand. And it was built in October of 1990, which may be a clue. I'm not sure. But yes, this is a hard drive we found on the scene. Now, a little bit of the details around the actual series of events that led us to 2 a.m. early this morning when we abducted a suspect, whose name will be withheld until we have further proof. We do not want to endanger the investigation as it stands now. We do have a bucketful, as you can see, of evidence. This is all very solid evidence. But at the same time, there's been a lot of complexities and twists and turns and theories about who did what, when, how. We're going to hold off on letting too many names go until we can figure out very specifically when and how this one particular individual, who's our prime suspect, came into the picture. Now, as you might know, Dr. Oblivion went missing about 4 weeks ago. Well, we have recovered Dr. Oblivion. I am happy to say he is alive. He's dehydrated, and he's being treated both for dehydration and exposure. We have also recovered Jim Groom, who's also dehydrated and being treated for exposure and for spider bites. Several spider bites on both Dr. Oblivion and Jim Groom that we're looking into. But we're happy to say that both of them are fine and they're rehabilitating as we speak. We're hopefully going to get some press in with them later today, if not tomorrow. But there is still a suspect that we have to deal with. And we're going to have a whole expose on this particular individual once we get and nail down, in fact, that he or she is our primary and only suspect. Now, there's also families out there who are wondering, DS-107 families, what happened to a number of their loved ones. And I can only say to them, I'm sorry. I'm sorry for what I've seen. I'm sorry for what has happened. And if I were you and part of their families, I would probably not come up to Camp Oblivion. I would not. We still haven't cleaned up all the mess. The woods are still drained in blood. And I would say, please stay home. Talk to your local authorities. Stay away from Camp Oblivion. Camp Oblivion is not a public space to come and commiserate and to grieve. You need to do that in your own space. Camp Oblivion is still an investigative, research-centered area. We will not accept the public here. Only the press, and at this point, the local authorities, and I believe the FBI are going to get involved, because somehow with this DS-106 class, which I guess is the hub of all this, it's not only happening here in Virginia, it's happening in other states, if not other countries, which ultimately brings the feds in and maybe even the CIA. So, that be the case, I like to work alone. I've worked alone for 25 years now. I solve cases alone. But I may not be able to control the full impact of this. And I don't think, like I said, this is an isolated incident. There is one prime suspect. But as my theory, and the theory of other great minds in criminal justice, that this was not done by one sole lone madman or madwoman. This is part of a larger conspiracy around the internet and beyond. And I'll take some of your questions about what conspiracies and how they may relate to this particular instance of DS-106. But before I take those questions, I want to make one thing clear and one thing clear right now. Anyone associated with DS-106, particularly people who are taking this class for credit, because in my mind, they're the people who have the most to gain by the unfortunate circumstances that came to be at Camp Oblivion. It's for those people in particular that I'm talking, and I'm talking to you. You need to, by Thursday, July 21st, archive your blog. If you're not keeping your domain and web host beyond the circumstances of this class, you need to archive your blog. Now, I will send out, Kim Droom, will send out specific instructions of how you do this. But let me make this clear. For purposes of the investigation of Camp Oblivion and the DS-106 massacre, your stuff needs to be archived no later than July 21st, which is this coming Thursday. And please look at the actual tutorial and very specific directions I give you. You have to follow them step by step. This is now a police investigation. And if you don't follow them step by step, you in many ways could abrogate the process and put yourself at risk. So please, follow these directions very, very closely. Any deviance will not be tolerated. Excuse me, one second. My inhaler. Okay. Now, I will take any questions from anyone in the press. Now, Kim Droom. Yes. Young lady.
Hello, my name.
Young man, Taylor.
Can you hear me?
Can you hear her? Good.
My name is Taylor Brin. Is this related to the NFL lockout at all in any way?
Well, there is some indirect relation between the NFL lockout and DS-106. The only real difference between the two is money. The adjunct professors had much of the same kind of reasoning as the NFL players and owners. They just didn't make as much money. But this is a good point, Taylor. And this brings us back to some of the kind of things that we never thought of before. It's not about how much money. It's purely about the introduction of money, whether it be the NFL strike or some adjunct positioning here at University of Mary Washington. Just a little bit. You add that little bit of money into the picture and everything changes. We saw that with the NFL strike. And we're seeing that here with DS-106, the bloody Camp Oblivion massacre. So yeah, there is a link. Now, whether it is a link to steroids and, well, no, steroids wouldn't matter here, would it? Taylor, would it? Is that what you're asking? Did you ask me about steroids? I'm not asking the questions here, Taylor. Either you are or I am. Freelance diamonds.
Just as interested in anything. Steroids, are they involved?
We did find steroids, yes. But not in the hands of the presumed killer. We found steroids amongst the DS-107s. It seemed like a group of students were doing steroids in order to get the assignments done on time. That's a whole nother question.
Tragic.
With mind-enhanced drugs to complete courses. This is a new thing we're finding. It's a national epidemic. But this is a new thing we're finding, and we find that DS-106 has the same problem.
Mr. Droom.
Yes.
Mr. Droom, George DiPaolo with Washington Times. Do you suspect any involvement by Google Plus at this time?
Google Plus. Well, Google Plus, you understand, that's a larger conspiracy we're looking at, right? That's a conspiracy which I'm linked to the boys at the Fed and the CIA.
Hey, it's a total... answer the question.
Excuse me, I'm trying to, George. George, if you let me answer the question, I'll answer the question. Are you here to report or are you here to upbraid me?
The people want to know.
Yeah, the people. I'm the people. I'll talk to the people when I'm ready. The people. What do the people know? If the people knew a goddamn thing, we wouldn't have 14 bodies lined up at Camp Oblivion, would we, George? Right? We wouldn't have a bloodbath. More to the point. I saw what was over there. You didn't. I saw the body and the blood and the bones. Okay, excuse me. I'm sorry. I need some Visine. Oh, God. Anyway, to your point, Google Plus, conspiracy theories. We're looking at Google Plus for a different conspiracy theory altogether, but of course it comes back to DS-106, because everything comes back to DS-106. If you let me speak, you'd realize that. It's called the Total Awareness Project. The feds refer to it, and the CIA refer to it as TAP. It's another device by which we know where everyone is at all times. And how that, hold on, and how that's related to Camp Oblivion is this particular killer brought the entire class, or at least most of the class, to a place that's off the grid. Very intelligent. Things like Google Plus, things like Facebook try and keep everybody on the grid. This killer was smart. It was premeditated. This wasn't just a series of madness. They tried to take people off the grid. And so that, Google Plus is related indirectly because they created the grid in the first place that this killer tried to get off of. If this killer didn't have to get off the grid, we might not have had a murder at all.
Mr. Droom.
Yes.
Is it true there were Swedish prostitutes found on Camp Oblivion ground?
Right now, I cannot confirm or deny this, but we did find Julia Assange in one of the cabins, yes. Now, whether they were Swedish prostitutes, I cannot say either yay or nay until I've inspected them personally.
I have another question.
Yes.
Freelance Diamonds is interested in whether Rupert Murdoch is involved with his wiretaps.
This is interesting. We're finding, right now, this is breaking news. We are finding that several of the DS-106 students, both open and online, and in classes, phones were hacked. They were hacked by Rupert Murdoch, who was trying to get this story before the Freelance Diamond and everybody else. So he's actually onto this story, and we're onto him, because the whole illusion right now, if I can speak both as a detective but as a citizen of this great country, the United States of America, the whole illusion right now with the press is that somehow the British media is distinct from the American media. It's all the same under Fox. It's all the same under News Corp. Don't let yourself be deluded by their little messages and their little ideas. DS-106 directly plays into this. You know why? Because it's yet another example of how the American media is going to try and twist this as the lone gunman, as the single gunwoman, if you will. I'm not sure this is the case in DS-106. This is a much larger outfit. And what they want is very simple. It's information.
My final question.
Yes.
Do you still believe that Halley's Comet was involved with the serial killings 20 years ago?
The Halley's Comet?
Halley's Comet.
The Halley's Comet? Who let you in here? Who let you in here?
I read that you believe.
Listen, if your comments aren't pertinent to the investigation at hand, I'm knee deep in this investigation. I don't care about a serial killer 20 years ago. Do you think it's the same serial killer? Let me tell you this. 20 years ago, this serial killer was in diapers, from what I know. So no, I don't think the two are related at all. And do I believe Halley Comet caused serial kills? Well, that's another book I wrote. I don't know if you read the book, but I've already said everything I wanted to say. Of course comets create serial killers. It's the stupidest question I ever heard. Next. Anything else? Okay, good. Now, let me repeat. This is an ongoing investigation. And if you're part of DS-106 for credit, you need to archive your blog by Thursday, July 21st. Everything in there needs to be done by the book, point by point. That tutorial is forthcoming, and this is an ongoing investigation, so please stay tuned for more information. Breaking news on the hour. DS-106, for life. For life.
Well, that you heard it, folks. There's the press conference, and I'm blown away. I'm still just so shocked to even hear that news. Clearly, Detective Kim Droom was able to find a lot of information, a lot of evidence, but we're still left with so many questions. My only hope is that Jim and Dr. Oblivion will come forth with more information in the next day or two, and that we can finally put this all to a rest. For now, I think I'm going to go blog. This is Timmy Boy signing out. Peace, love, goodbye.